this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. And today I'm in my compost alley where I got over a dozen different composters actually lined up that I've been composting all my food scraps and the majority of my yard waste. Contaminated yard waste actually gets sent off-site, but most of it I try to compost on-site. Don't like sending anything off-site if I can avoid it, except if it's to avoid disease in the garden. In any case, because I have so many composters, and if you're wondering, John, what's the best composter to buy? Well, check the link down below where I review all 12 composters that I have, and I share with you guys the pros and cons of each ones, and the ones, of course, that I like more. But of course, the end result of composting is making compost. So that's what I'm doing today. We got the lifetime composter here that we're gonna go ahead and open up, and inside here, we have all this finished compost. This is kind of like my end holding tank after one of my drawer forms get done, and they're pretty well composted. I'll put it in here and kind of like let it mellow out for a couple more months to make sure I'm getting a nice good finished compost and not something that's just only partially degraded down like you'd buy at many stores, in my opinion. But once I get it all composted down, the next step, I can't just put like big chunks of stuff, you know, like in my garden. I mean, you could do that. I like things a bit more precise, and you know, while this will break down over time and feed the microorganisms in your plants, I want to give the most broken down compost to my plants to get the most valuable uptake of nutrients, and then the rest of the stuff, the sticks and stones that might break my bones, and the names will hurt you, actually go back into the composters to get composted out. So, you know, if you guys seen my previous videos, what I usually use is just a wheelbarrow, and then over here, we'll get out. I made a compost sifter, and this is a nice compost sifter. I mean, I think it cost me under $20 to make, just added some 2x4s and some 1x2 or something like that. And basically, oh, and you want to know how to make this? Check the link down below. Super simple, super easy. This has been working really well for me. Basically, I take bucketfuls of the compost, I shove it in here, and then I shake this out to get all my compost, and then all the screening stuff off the top goes back into one of my composters. And today being spring, it's a perfect time to start amending your soil, get the compost in there, add rock dust, add the worm castings, add all the other good stuff that I like to add before you plant out for your new summer season that for some of you guys is already here and some of you guys is coming up real soon. And so aside from just using this method, actually I got another compost sifter, actually a rolling composter, compost sifter in the mail. So what I'll do first is I'm gonna go ahead and basically get one square bucket of compost, dump it in here, see how long it takes to shake it out, sift it out. You'll get to see the whole process like fast forward, sped up style. I'll time it with my iPhone, and then we're gonna go ahead and open up the new rolling sifter to see if it saves me some time. All right, so I guess first step, let me go ahead and get a whole bucket of compost loaded up, ready to go on trial.
We just wanted to take a moment out of this episode today to remind you guys that we're still doing, for a limited time, the Growing Your Greens t-shirt fundraiser. So if you want to support me and my work, you could definitely buy a Growing Your Greens t-shirt that directly supports me to allow me to continue to make my educational videos. Plus, you definitely get a really cool organic cotton Growing Your Greens t-shirt that says Growing Your Greens on the front and the back. If you guys can see that. Grow greens, eat greens, and be green, right? Greens are the most important food on the planet. Show your support by purchasing your organic Growing Your Greens t-shirt for a limited time only. This is athletic fit. This is the kind of fit I like it, so it shows how buffed I am on a plant-based diet. So yeah, check the link down below. CompassionTees.com. Link is also at the end of this video. So when you're done watching the video, click over and support me while you still can, and also get a cool organic t-shirt at the same time.
So it took about a minute and a half to sift out all that compost with the standard sifter that I used, and here's the results. All looks pretty good to me. And next I wanna go ahead and try the rolling sifter. And this is actually made in the USA. I got contacted by one Cheryl Smith in Louisiana, who basically spent 2 years to develop this very sifter. Now, it's pretty light when you get it shipped to you. The problem is she ships through priority mail, which in my opinion is not the most economical way to ship things. It's pretty fast, but this thing costs $65 to ship to you. So I would recommend that she starts using FedEx ground and get some pre-negotiated discounts through some associations. That'll definitely knock the shipping charges at least in half easily, so that you guys could pay a lower price for the sifter. All right, let's go ahead and open this up first time on the camera, see what the heck is inside the box here. I've only seen a few YouTube videos on this. All right, so it's basically says, John, one man said it fits his walk wheelbarrow perfect. I don't know. Anyways, so inside here you have lots of compostable materials, so I'm glad she's not using those styrofoam peanuts. Just got this paper. What I like to do on this newsprint is I'll run it through my shredder that micro shreds things to a fine particle size, and then that stuff will end up going in my compost bins. All right, so let's see. So yeah, we got a lot of newsprint stuff. Oh, and then check this out, man. You got our pre-assembled PVC frame, and this is designed to sit on any standard wheelbarrow. So that's really cool. I like that this basically pretty much comes pre-assembled. Let's see inside here. That's pretty much it. The box could also be fully composted. Let's go ahead and, oh, and then on this guy, this is what it looks like. It's just basically a rolling sifter. It's just basically, it's got two ends here, and actually these two ends looks like you could just basically spin off the end here and have access to it. And so we're just gonna go ahead and take out the news print. And then inside here, it looks like we just got some additional screen material, and there are no instructions. So good thing I don't read English, because there's no instructions to read anyways. Actually, I do read English. But this guy is pretty much basic. I mean, basically it looks like some kind of like screen material, galvanized with two nice ends here on it. That's actually, looks like it's silicone glued in there fairly nicely with some tie wraps that kind of hold it together. And basically these ends are like kind of screw off like this. And you know, to me, what this looks like, this kind of looks like those, what are those things? The gamma lids, right? For like a 5 gallon bucket. So anyways, what you do then is you got these additional screens. So this currently comes in like a half inch size screen. And over here you got a quarter inch. So if you want to do a quarter inch, you could basically affix this on here to have quarter inch. And then if you want to do something like worm casting, something even finer, then you could do something like this, which is eighth inch, so you could have even a finer size. You know, the eighth inch might be good for like true worm castings, but pretty much I like to use the quarter inch for everything I'm doing. And this is actually held together with some ties here, so you do want to hold on to these ties because you will be reusing these. And let's go ahead and take this apart here. So that's pretty much it, two ends. And so what I'm gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and roll this around one, and we're gonna try to like affix it inside here. So it kind of goes in to one of the ends, and then we're gonna kind of like put this on pretty tight. Then we're gonna take one of these ties and we're gonna affix it on to affix the screen on. I think we'll use two ties, one for each end. All right, so we got one half done. Let's go ahead and put the other half on. All right, so I got this all secured with my quarter inch now on there, and we're just gonna go ahead and set that down. Actually, maybe we're gonna go ahead and set this guy up, this frame. This frame is not glued in place, so it's adjustable should you need to do that. And let's go ahead and bend it in place. And so this is designed to basically sit on top of your wheelbarrow. Let's see if it's sitting on top of mine. So I think we got to adjust it. I think it's probably adjustable a little bit. Oops, pull it too hard. So it looks like this is standard PVC. So all right, we're gonna put that there and put it on this side here. Oh, and it's a little bit too short for my wheelbarrow here. Let's pull this out a little bit adjustable. Might have to cut some new PVC there to make it fit. All right, so having some issues not fitting on my wheelbarrow that's basically from Home Depot. Let's see. It's like a little bit too short. Like maybe they need to have some pieces that are like longer, and then you could cut it to size if your wheelbarrow is a little bit more narrow, but like I can't really make this longer because there's no extra PVC. Let's see if I move this up to the end or something and maybe I can get it to fit because the wheelbarrow is not quite as wide. All right, yeah, I mean, I try to fit this on. I got one side pretty good, but the other side doesn't fit, and then it just comes apart. So let me go and see if I have any extra spare, maybe like quarter inch PVC tubing so I could actually cut my own pieces. All right, so good gardeners always got spare supplies around, laying around, and trust me, if you guys saw my place, I got all kinds of stuff, extra things and parts and things for gardening laying around. You know, I probably need like a dedicated storage shed to store all this stuff, and I know some of you guys' wives or husbands might complain, why are you storing that? Well, because you never know when you're gonna need it, and it might really enable you to make finish a video that you don't have to go to the store and buy more PVC to finish later. Anyways, I found some PVC tubing here, quarter inch, or actually, sorry, 3/4 inch laying around. Actually, this is thick wall, so this is actually nice stuff. And basically, it appears to be the same exact size of tubing that they sent me that did not fit. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and take my handy PVC cutters. I got from Harbor Freight Tool, and we're just gonna go ahead and maybe measure this and make sure we get a nice size here. Oh, yep, fits right in good. Maybe we'll take out this other small piece too, and put in my other large piece there. All right. So that should go like that, and then we need to basically just line this up so that it kind of sits on here like this. And then we need to cut it to fit probably right about there, actually. If we got it to fit, let's go ahead and put this end on. Wait, it goes like this. Make sure it's nice and tight. Ugh. Check it out. It fits. Let's flip it over this way, actually. All right, there we go. Had to modify things. All right, so now that we got that contraption fit, what's supposed to happen is you're supposed to put the compost in here, put this on top, and then roll it to get the compost out, right? And that's gonna be a lot easier than shaking it back and forth and shaking my moneymaker. So let's see if this works, all right? So first step is I'm gonna go ahead and get another bucket, 5-gallon bucket of compost so that we have an even comparison. Alright, so I think that'll do it. I've got about one even 5-gallon bucket loaded up here. I think the next step is we're just gonna go ahead and turn on the stopwatch here. And then we're gonna go ahead and carefully dump this in the rolling sifter. right, so as I'm doing this, compost is already coming out of the sides. Really cool. Once I got that all in there, then we're gonna go ahead and spin the top on. This could be like a Fred Flintstone wheel. All right, and then we're gonna go ahead and distribute this evenly. Then we're gonna put it on here. This is gonna be a heck of a lot easier. We're just gonna go ahead and spin this and see how long it takes. I'm not gonna go too fast because it kind of flings the compost everywhere. All right, I think I'm about done here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the time. So that took about 2.5 minutes. And basically, if you guys were watching, what happened? So at first I was kind of going really slow, figuring this would just basically work. And I found that, yeah, some stuff would be coming out and that's pretty good. But I found when I went really fast, it would really throw stuff everywhere and actually around my wheelbarrow on the ground, I have a lot of like compost that got flung everywhere. Now I use this completely sealed in. I have seen videos online where they actually have this uncorked, so any excess could kind of fall out as you're going, and plus you would then be able to, you know, kind of like get your hand in there. Let's go ahead and undo this guy. We'll get another container here. Put that underneath, and so the way I saw it demonstrating online was basically you turn it like this, and actually the excess kind of comes out. So I kind of like using it open method, because in the closed method sometimes I like to go around and like kind of grab compost and kind of like squeeze it to see if I get the smaller particle size. Plus I kind of like to rub my hands back and forth along it to see if I can get anything to squeeze through the holes and to bust up some of the large particles to get it to come out. So when you do it like this, basically a lot of the rolling stuff, the big stuff, will tend to kind of go out into the bucket down below or the collection barrel, and the smaller stuff will kind of go in. So I kind of like using it like this a little bit better. And pretty much I'm seeing that it is doing a good job at basically getting out all the large particle size and rocks, you know, that's gonna go back through my compost system. And if I do this long enough, I mean, I think I pretty much got all the particles. So let's go ahead and basically, I like that the rest is actually contained within here, so I could just easily go to one of my other compost bins here and dump all the stuff in there, or just then tap this out. And so, yeah, so here's the thing, right? I like gimmicks. Does this gimmick have a place in your garden? That depends. So, you know, this was definitely easier to use and took less muscle. So if you're like a lady and you don't want to be shaking your moneymaker and shaking your compost sifter like I was doing earlier, you know, back and forth, the manual method. You know, it's definitely more calm and sane. I think it'll also take you a little bit longer, right? But I personally like having the screen open, or the sifter open, so I can actually brush my hand through there and kind of more actively see what's going on, because I have a lot of funky, like, particles, avocados, sticks, that sometimes I need to, like, kind of help push through the sieve there and through the grate. Now, if you had something like worm castings, you know, I could see that this kind of sifter would work really good. Or, you know, say you were, like, taking off, like pulling up old soil and had a lot of roots in there, you could put it through this sifter that would kind of like rotate it, bounce it up and down, so that you don't have to shake it vigorously back and forth, so you don't have to. So, you know, for the right purpose, I think this is great. The other thing actually I would have done on this, they made it go in this direction, which actually doesn't give it a whole lot of like mass on the inside, although it did easily hold 5 gallons of my finished compost. I'd actually designed it to go this direction so that out the front, that's where all the stuff could fall, and then you'd get a little bit longer so you could actually have more compost in there sifting at the same time. I like that it has 3 different options for the screens. I think it works pretty good for what it is. Now the main challenge I have is that I'm pretty damn frugal, like you guys know. I mean, I made this sifter here for like 15, 20 bucks at most. This guy will set you back, I think it's like 80 bucks, and then plus you gotta pay another $30 for shipping. And the shipping you guys saw on the label for me was $63 for them to ship it to me, which is basically what you're paying for are, to me, it looks like 2 ends to like a gamma lid, which is basically a screwable, 5 gallon bucket top with some screen material. So you guys could make one of these really super simple. Oh, and then also, of course, you have to align the screen properly, and then you're gonna use some kind of silicone glue to glue it in there. And if I was to do this, I would just personally make 3 different sizes. I would make a 1/2 inch, I'd make a 1/4 inch, and I'd make an 1/8 inch, so that I don't have to keep, basically tying the smaller screen size to the larger one. You know, this may also play a problem too, because the smaller grid sizes tend not to be as sturdy as the larger ones that have a thicker gauge wire. But all in all, I think for the right person, you know, if this gimmick or rolling sifter allows you to sift your compost easily and you like it, I think that's great. Or if you want to get, the standard one that I use, I think although I have this one, and then I also want to talk about the base here. You know, this base, let's face it, guys, I'm not going to lie to you, this is made out of like some 3/4 inch connectors here, mostly T's. Some corners and some 90 degrees and some PVC tubing to put on top, which actually didn't even fit my wheelbarrow. So, you know, I think that'd be a critical point to make sure that it fit all the wheelbarrows out there, and if not, include different size poles or at least longer poles so that somebody could trim it down to the size they have, because you can't elongate it, right? And so this isn't that complicated to make. I'm glad that Cheryl is making these available for people that don't want to do it yourself, because I know a lot of you guys are gardeners and you're not also DIYers. I'm a DIYer gardener, so I like fabricate things, make my own things, fix things, but some of you guys just plain don't like to do that. So, you know, if you're not going to make your own sifter, you know, you could at least buy one of these guys. I find it work well, and I kind of like it. I'd like to actually make the diameter on it a little bit larger myself, but I could see how they've designed it this way and it goes together pretty easily. I wish the shipping costs were less, and I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, I think in the end I'll say I'm gonna stick with my standard sifter. This guy, I like it, and you know, hey, if I ever do worm castings, I want to sift worm castings, I think this is probably better for worm castings, just because worm castings don't have a lot of big particles. The compost I sift tends to have a lot of big particles, but you know, sometimes if I'm sifting out like stuff from my yard, like that I'm like scraping off old raised bed soil, I want to sift it out and then get the roots out, I think this would actually probably be better than this guy. So once again, like I have a whole bunch of different shovels I like to use in my garden. You could have a whole bunch of different compost sifters, but make sure if you're gonna get one, make sure you're actually gonna get your money's worth out of it. You know, composting is one of the most valuable things you guys can do for your garden, is compost your food scraps, also your plant material, and make sure you add in things like the rock dust and also the biochar in your compost to make it even more nutritious for next year's plants. If you guys are interested in getting one of these rolling sifters, please be sure to check the link down below. I've contacted Cheryl, and hopefully she's provided you some special YouTube discounts. So look down below in the description for any discounts for my viewers, since I review this for you guys, so you guys know what it's about. And that's pretty much it for this episode. If you guys enjoyed this episode, this review format, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. I got a lot more compost to sift out today, so I got to get running. Also be sure to share this video with somebody else that hates their manual sifting or doesn't have a sifter. I think this is a great option for some people to get them more excited about composting, because it is kind of cool and it's definitely a lot less work to kind of spin this thing than to shake this guy back and forth. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on any of my new and upcoming episodes of coming out about every 3 to 4 days, you never know, worship or what you'd be learning on my YouTube channel. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, over 1,300 episodes at this time, teach you guys all aspects on how you guys could grow your own food at home. So with that, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.